made it home, I dug her out, then I made her one of my aces. Marijuana fragrance, this tree here is outrageous. Want me to play in your city, send an email to my agent.
Yo, what's going down, everybody? It is Straight Outta Boston here, aka the King of Boston, and today we are back for episode 26 of the Utah Jazz Association on NBA 2K13. And today we're going up against the Golden State Warriors. Really the surprise team of the playoffs, in real life at least, for many. Now that I wasn't too surprised by it, I picked them to win in round one in six games. Actually, honestly, I picked them in round two as well, but that was more being a Warriors fan than anything else. Anyway, if you guys don't know, the Warriors are one of my favorite teams. I'm currently working on a new blog post on my sports blog about the Golden State Warriors. I'm writing a eulogy. If you guys don't know what a eulogy is, it's like a thing someone would say at a funeral for someone. So I was writing the Warriors season eulogy, but anyway, it's kind of a funny thing. So you can go check that out if you're interested in the Warriors. Not quite up yet, but it'll probably be up by the time... Well, I don't know about if it's going to be up by the time this video goes up. We'll see about that. Probably not, actually. Let's be honest here. Anyway, so we're going up against the Warriors. This is a very good all-around team. This is a fully healthy Warriors team that really hasn't changed much, since, you know, this association started. Now, they are 30-51. We are 49-32, so I have to quickly explain the situation. A win puts us in the 3 seed. A loss for the 7 seed. This game is huge. There are four other teams that are 50-32. If we do get the win, though, we will move up to that 3 seed. If we lose, we won't have a home court advantage for likely any series in the playoffs, and it would be a really rough situation if we lost and fell to that 7 seed. So, Warriors, really not much to play for, but on the other hand, the Jazz have a lot to play for, so hopefully we'll have at least a competitive advantage there. But you can see this Warriors team really has not changed. They still have Steph Curry, Klay Thompson, Harrison Barnes, David Lee, and Andrew Bogut in their starting lineup. Now, I really like this starting lineup for the Warriors. We really haven't seen David Lee and Andrew Bogut healthy playing together at all since the trade to acquire Andrew Bogut actually happened. So I'm excited for that next season. Hopefully they can both stay healthy. And, you know, Bogut really wasn't himself all year. He was still recovering from that ankle. So even the, you know, whatever 30 games that he did play, they really weren't the Andrew Bogut that we're used to seeing. So anyway, 17-9, a quick start for the Utah Jazz. We have our second unit in right here. Raymond Felton dishes it off to Harrison Barnes. I swear, the Warriors always get Raymond Felton. They always make some sort of trade with the New York Knicks to get Raymond Felton in, like, all these associations and these my players, all of it. But anyway, Ben McLemore with the ball. He's going to dish it off to Derek Favors, who's going to hit the mid-range jumper right there. So we take a 7-point lead. Looking really good to start off, 28-16. Steph Curry with the ball. He finds Harrison Barnes wide open from mid, and Harrison Barnes to really emerge this postseason as a very elite, well, not elite, but a very good young small forward who will be there for the future for a while for that Golden State Warriors team. Evan Fournier with the ball, dribbling it around. This is the one thing I really like about Evan Fournier besides his shooting is his ball handling. Gets in the lane for the one-hand slam there. Eric Bledsoe trying to go to work. He gets double-teamed. He's looking, he actually breaks the double team and gets the one-handed slam. So we go up by 16 as the first quarter does end. Time winds down, and we end up on top 36-20. So a very good first quarter. Offense showed up, or defense showed up. Everything really went well. We're firing on all cylinders once again. But you can never count the Golden State Warriors out. With that three-point shooting, who knows what could happen. That's one of the reasons that I really like this team, the Warriors, for the future, is that you can't count them out of a game. Anyway, Nikola Vucevic hits the three there. Nice pass by Andre Miller. He's doing what he does. He has three assists. 41-27, Klay Thompson dribbles the ball up. He dishes it off to Carl Landry, and Landry puts that one in. So 41-29 is your score. Now it's 31-43. Klay Thompson on the steal. Steph Curry to Harrison Barnes. Barnes driving in. Poster time! Harrison Barnes! Check it out on the Sprite Slam cam one more time. Harrison Barnes dunking all over Kyle Korver. That was absolutely embarrassing. I probably just killed all earphone users, but you know what? Live with it. Anyway, so we're going to advance to the next clip here. It is 45-33. Evan Fournier with the ball, calling for the screen from Enes Kanter. Fournier takes a fading three. I actually didn't mean to shoot that, but it works out as Evan Fournier now 3-3 from the field, 1-1 from three. A great game so far for him with 9 early points. Now, it looks like Trey Burke, yes, the real TB3, Trey Burke on the one-handed layup right there. Looks like he has been drafted by the Golden State Warriors as a bench player, but oh well, Raymond Felton dishes it off to Brandon Rush, and Rush gets that mid-range to go. Brandon Rush, the forgotten man on this Warriors team. He did tear his ACL in, I believe, the second game of the season, so he really was not around all season. I'll be curious to see if he comes back next year with the emergence of Draymond Green and Klay Thompson. I don't know where Brandon Rush is going to fit into that rotation, but we'll see. Anyway, 54-45. Bledsoe taking a three. Bledsoe bringing it, but whoa, Nikola Vucevic. Seems like he does that like once or twice a game. I don't know, man. He's crazy athletic, apparently. Raymond Felton, though, dishes that off to Brandon Rush once again, who was left wide open and cannot do that with a shooter like Brandon Rush. So the score going into halftime is going to be 62-49. The Jazz are on top of the Golden State Warriors. Like I said, this is a must-win game for the Warriors. We really need this win. We don't want to enter the playoffs as a 7 seed. We've worked so hard to get over that slow start and get to this point. Also, 50 wins would be a pretty good benchmark for us. So, anyway, Steph Curry off to Andrew Bogut. Bogut's going to hit the little short-range jump shot right there on his ugly, ugly jump shot, but all well. 62-53. Paul George going to work on Klay Thompson. Hop step in the lane and one. You knew it. That's right. That animation always seems to end up in and one, so I really like it. But 65-55 now. Eric Bledsoe trying to go to work on Steph Curry. Gets by, hop step into the lane, and gets it to go. Eric Bledsoe stepped it up a little bit. I usually don't score with him too often when I do use these Warriors. But anyway, Steph Curry misses the floater there. Andrew Bogut on the boards, though. No one boxed him out. And the lead's down to 8, so the Warriors are not going to go away just yet. Now it's 67-59. Bledsoe dishes it off to Favors, who is going to hit a wide-open Paul George for 3, and that one is good. So we go back up by 11. Now 74-63, this is where Steph Curry started to get hot. He's going to give it to David Lee, though, and David Lee is going to hit the mid-range jumper right there, so the lead's back down to 9. But now Steph Curry, once again, 67-76. Curry's doing some crossover moves. I backed off, and you can't back off Curry like that. He'll pop that 3. One of the quickest releases, if not the quickest release in the NBA. Now David Lee dribbling around, triple threat moves. Actually, he's going to find a wide-open Steph Curry. Lazy defense by Eric Bledsoe. And the Steph Curry three-point shooting has cut this lead to 2. 78-76. Now Curry going to work. Behind the back move, he dribbles in, dishes it off to David Lee for the one-handed layup, and it's just like that. 78-78. Now Raymond Felton with the ball being covered by Evan Fournier. He finds a cutting Steph Curry for 3. It's good, and the Warriors have taken the lead. This is what I'm talking about with this three-point shooting. You cannot count this team out of the game. Anyway, Kenyon Martin going to work in the post. Up and under. Nope, he's going to give it to Kyle Korver for 3, and that one is good. So Korver answers right back, and we're going to enter the fourth quarter with an 83-83 ball game, all tied up. Great comeback by the Golden State Warriors, but we've seen their fourth quarter execution firsthand in the playoffs before. We'll see if they continue to struggle with that in this association. So 83 all, Jabari Parker with the ball. He crosses over into the lane, hop step, left hand, and one. Beautiful, beautiful moves by Jabari Parker. Really good to see him still being that consistent scorer. Hasn't really hit the rookie wall yet. That's really good for us. Steph Curry now with the ball, dribbling up. He's going to take the floater, and man, the Steph Curry floater is just too nice. He's got 20 points now. It's 7 of 10 shooting in the second half. He's at 18 in the third quarter, or he had like 16 in the third quarter. He's done really well. Nice bounce pass by Jabari Parker to Eric Bledsoe for the lane. Thought about alley-ooping that one, but I made the safe play, and it paid off. So 90-89 now. Steph Curry wide open in the corner. It's good. Steph Curry once again. We got to find a way to stop this kid if we do want to win this game. Whether it's double team, switching defenders on him, who knows. But he makes a nice pass right there to David Lee. Great court vision by Steph Curry. And the Warriors extend their lead to 4 points down there. So it looks like they might pull away here. The Jazz need to overcome some adversity. This is one of the toughest spots to be in. Nice move by Eric Bledsoe. He got Steph Curry on his heels or whatever. And the nice pull-up mid-range right there by Bledsoe. He really stepped it down. Now Paul George on the block. And great vision by Eric Bledsoe, who noticed that George leaked out after he got the block. So Bledsoe immediately got the rebound and threw that off to Paul George. So Nikola Vucevic fading on the hook shot right there. Gets it to go. That was a mismatch in the post. He had Klay Thompson on him. So we take the lead once again, overcoming that adversity. Like I said, one of the toughest spots to be in the basketball game was kind of that spot where they've made a run. They've taken the lead. You know, you're on your heels. But the Warriors aren't going to go away yet after a layup right there. Now it's 103-102. Eric Bledsoe into the lane. He's been the man all night. Up and under. It's good. 18 points for Eric Bledsoe. We take the 1-point lead. So now Steph Curry. What can Steph do? Trying to cross over. He pulls up. No good. Nikola Vucevic chases down the rebound. He will get fouled and go to the line. Actually, I believe, or he will not go to the line. It would be inbounded to Eric Bledsoe. Now, he would miss the first one, so he's going to miss the second intentionally. Andrew Bogut on the boards after step. The full court shot is no good. So, we end up winning this ballgame 104-103. A very tight victory, but a good victory nonetheless. A win is a win. That's all we were looking for in this game. We get the win. We get that 3 seed locked up, and that's all we really wanted. So, anyway, that is pretty much going to wrap up this video. I will save the postgame, awards and stuff. The regular season awards, first team, second team, all that crap. I'll save that for the next episode more than likely. So anyway, that is going to wrap up this game. But you see, we won 104-103. Pretty even match. Categories for teams went both ways. Eric Bledsoe did get your player of the game, so I was really glad to see that. Eric Bledsoe has really fallen into the shadows this season, so to say, with the emergence of Paul George and Derek Favors. But you know what? I don't want Eric Bledsoe to go away. His penetration and, playmaking off of that penetration is key to us. So that pretty much wraps up this video. Go like me on Facebook, follow me on Twitter, and if you want, you can go follow my sports blog. All three links are in the description. Thank you guys for watching. I really hope you did enjoy. Hope you guys are excited for the playoffs that will be coming up in the next episode. And so I'm out. Peace.